I'm 98 years old, thank God. But one of the things that I can really appreciate while I was in Selma, that when we grew up, my father didn't allow us to go into the segregated areas. My mother went to town, bought our shoes and clothes, and brought them back, and because he didn't want us to grow up with a negative attitude. African American lived on one side of the town, and whites on the other side of the town. And where we lived, it was not paved. It was all dirt, but my father and all of the other men got together, and they sprayed the streets so that the dust would not fly in the houses and things. And of course, we thought that was wonderful. I was really surprised when I finished high school and attempted to get on the bus. That was the first time that I had ever seen a bus and saw African Americans had to sit on the back seat. You had to stand outside and go up to the window and get a ticket because you were not permitted to go in where all the people bought the tickets. This is Selma. And when I saw that, I said, that's interesting. Because when you went in there, it was just unbelievable that they would keep someone from going into a place that was so limited. That was the attitude that we had. And a lot of us used to get together and laugh. I have pictures of friends of mine. We used to get in the room while we were waiting, because you had a segregated room, you had to wait to get your ticket to get on the bus. And when you got on the bus, the bus driver would make sure that you went in the very back. But some of us would stand up, we wouldn't sit, because we were determined we were not going to sit in a segregated bus. Now, this happened in South. And for a long time, when I came here, I went back to Selma every month to see what was going on. And I tell you, it was just shocking to see the changes that had come about. But I found that the segregation was not only in the South, it was undercover in the North. And you had to know how to exist without having to allowing that to change your attitude.